All right, team, welcome back to After Hours. We have a banger of a show for you today. We are wrapping up this November, talking about some of the best performers of this month. The end of November is in 5 days, so I kind of want to talk about some altcoins that have performed well, Maddie. I know there are some altcoins that are lagging, like HNT right now, looking at like a 4% negative monthly close, but then you have the other altcoins that are performing well. So, team, it is not a moment for you to just start chucking money into the altcoin market. It's never wise to do that. It is best to go strategically in, and we teach you how to do that at CryptoCharge.com. Click the pin link down below. We'll take you over to CryptoCharge. Sign up there. Use code YouTube. You have the shows, the Discord, the community over there. Do that. Maddie, first thing I want to talk about here is we are looking to see a big monthly close in Bitcoin here within the next 5 days, just to show that bullish continuation here and a break of structure. And here's a couple important dates from the past here. May 2017 was the big monthly close. October 2020, big monthly close. And that is what we are trying to see for this November here. How are you looking for Bitcoin to finish up this month?
You know, I think that we've had a plenty strong, monthly candle produced so far here for Bitcoin. Of course, the close always determines the actual strength of that candle. But this has been plenty strong of a breakout. We've seen all the confirmation we need to see over those previous all-time highs. Again, I'm still looking for, especially after the breakouts we've seen both in Bitcoin and the altcoin market, some sort of correction in here, some sort of cool off. It's definitely been a very aggressive break. And that's what you want to see after an extended consolidation period like that. But Bitcoin looks absolutely beautiful. You know, we could even close our monthly candle, let's say, you know, somewhere in the 80,000s, and it would still be a plenty strong candle close. We look at a different type of candle. What you guys will see most traders, including myself, talk about on most daily candles and weekly candles, monthly candles, is the traditional Japanese candles. But there's also another type of candle that takes the same elements, open, high, low, close, and organizes it a different way. And those are Heikin-Ashi candles. And one of the things that we're seeing on the Heikin-Ashi candles is we're seeing no lower wicking on those. We're seeing strong candle bodies form on the monthly. So that really shows me that there's still a lot of strength left in the Bitcoin market. And of course, we're seeing a lot of altcoins do great breakouts here as well. So like you said, Gav, we've got a few more days here until that monthly candle close, but it's looking great to me.
Maddie, something I want to talk about here. So we got shit on in the bear market, all right, for our altcoin picks. We weren't buying the right assets. We weren't buying Sui. We weren't buying Render. We weren't buying Aptos. We were buying XRP, Zcash, and, you know, a plethora of other altcoins here. And I just got to say, Thursday and Friday of last week was pretty fun for me, just staring at my coin stats, looking at TradingView, all the text messages I got, because Thursday and Friday showed me the catch up, and like a real catch up. You know, we saw that, we were talking about it on Monday of last show, of last week, talking about, you know, this big boom in the altcoin market. But Thursday and Friday of last week kind of showed me that continuation. And Maddie, let's just talk about some altcoins here for a second, just to kind of shit on the people that doubted us here. You know, of course, Bitcoin's probably going to close around 35% this month in November. 35% gain, pretty admirable. Ethereum 37, so Ethereum outperforming Bitcoin. But then let's get into some R picks here. API 3, 29%. Zcash 33%. So a little underperforming Bitcoin and ETH as of right now. Let's get into our major picks. XRP 189%, HBAR 195%. I know this technically isn't our pick because I swapped my XLM for XRP, and I know Maddie did too. XLM 448%. That's crazy, Maddie. So what do you have to say to the people that doubted us?
You know, guys, this is just a perfect example that the whole market doesn't go all at once. Yes, we can see flurries, we can see initial signs, maybe some nice, you know, daily candle closes that show there's a little bit of strength, but rotations occur, right? Like, and I think a lot of you guys forget that in the bear market, because you just get so sick of the bear market behavior, and you see a few odd laggards or a few outliers start to kind of just do their thing first, and you're like, damn it, that was the one. This is the only altcoin that's going to run this cycle. You moron, you picked the wrong coin, right? So it points to a couple things. One, that rotations do occur. Two, that when you pick strong fundamental picks, I'm not worried about what's happening in the short term, right? A lot of you guys have this very myopic vision of it needs to happen today for today, or it's not happening at all. Or all the gains have already been had in the meme coin market, and it's never going to happen for my coin, right? And all of this, again, is happening on the coattails of very tiny drops in Bitcoin dominance. We have seen nothing close to a cascade. The macro uptrend of Bitcoin dominance is still a very steep exponential uptrend right now. So all of these early breakout signs is really beautiful here, especially, you know, the XRP breakout. You know, a lot of people just told me that I was an idiot, you know, Matt, Ripple suppressing XRP price. You don't understand. This is a scam coin created by Ripple. Like, that doesn't make any sense, right? So, secondly, here's the price action you guys have been asking for. We've erased a 6-year downtrend, basically, in a matter of days here. You know, and we have a lot of other altcoins here that are just really still in the very early stages of a breakout. Zcash poked well above that $50 mark. We're getting ready for a run here, guys. Zcash is probably going to double up here in the coming days. API3 still on the verge of a breakout. There's still opportunities out there, right? But what do we not want to do, guys? And I'm begging, especially our new team, to figure this out. Do not chase big green candles, right? I didn't chase it on Sui. I didn't chase it on Render. And there's a lot of coins right now that are up, even though they're good picks, that I would beg you guys not to chase right now, because there's other opportunities that give you better risk to reward ratio that have not made those breakout moves. So if this is anything, it's a lesson in patience. It's a lesson in conviction. When you really have done research and you're not just invested in a bunch of microcap shit coins that you just hope do really, really well, diversification and patience goes a long way.
Yeah, even with Casper up 113%, by the way, which is crazy. You know, if you look at that green candle on TradingView, it is a crazy look. That is pretty impressive to see here. And, you know, yes, Maddie, you don't want to be aping in. I know I've cut all my purchasing right now, only looking at, I was looking at API3 this month and a little bit of Casper. And I got back on uphold, which is crazy. Last thing I wanted to touch on, Maddie, just because somewhere in the bear market there, you know, you were talking a lot about legacy assets. I had not dipped my toes into some of the, you know, top 5, top 10 cryptos that were created. And, you know, we're talking about like Bitcoin Cash all the time and EOS and Zcash. And at some point in the bear market, you just kind of consolidated them and you went into Zcash. I did want to talk about, for those naysayers that are like, oh, the old coins, they don't get those looks. Well, you had Zcash at 33% this month. You had Bitcoin Cash at 39%, Litecoin and Dash, EOS 84%, and nice. The legacy of all legacy assets, XRP 189%. Very impressive there. So, Maddie, we can't really count the legacy coins out. We can't count out those dinosaur coins, because they are here to stay, you know, team. And it's important to diversify your crypto portfolio and look at different sectors in crypto. The legacy coins, you know what we're going to talk about. It's Zcash for us. We are in the privacy sector right now with Zcash, buying Zcash. And so that's what we're doing right now. You might want to think about it. Last thing I want to talk about, Maddie, because this is something you've been preaching about. I've heard you preach about for 3 years. I just want to flash it here. Black Friday sale coming up. You want to talk about it?
Please get on this shit, guys. I mean, if you use my link, I get like a $15 credit. So that's really not what I'm worried about. But I do care about you guys getting the absolute best deal humanly possible. So for whatever reason, I feel like a lot of you guys have been in crypto for multiple years and you decide that having trading software is not an important part of your investing journey. That should stop today. Like this should stop this week. 70% off plus one free month. So like the premium plan, which I literally think that the majority of people do not need because it's just an abundance of features that the average person doesn't need, is $200 for the year plus an additional month with this Black Friday sale. Usually even with the plus plan, you're going to pay somewhere around like $22 to $25 a month without the discount on a monthly basis. Obviously, if you go annual, save a little bit of money. But please, guys, capitalize even on just the essentials plan for the Black Friday sale here. It's so essential for you guys, no pun intended there, for you guys to have at least some plan. The base level plan is perfectly fine. Use my link, don't use my link. I really don't care. I want you guys to at least consider jumping on this Black Friday deal. This usually runs through Cyber Monday, so you guys have a little bit of time to mull it over. Tell your partner that this is an important purchase that you should not neglect. And I think this is something that needs to be in your arsenal. I told you guys that, you know, I've used a lot of different trading software, a lot of different platforms over the last 9 years of studying, charting, being a student of the markets here. The absolute best dollar for value and just overall usability is TradingView. So please check it out. Black Friday, 70% off. Again, use my link. Don't use my link. I just want you guys to have the best software out there. And this is literally the best time out of any point during the year you can make a purchase of TradingView.
Love that. We'll drop Maddie's link down below, or maybe my link. We'll see whose link gets down there first. Very important you do that. Just kind of touch on this really quick, because I know like we shit on the people that go into CoinMarketCap and look at the cryptos and that don't really have a good scale. For you people that I hear that are like very new here, it's like, you know, if you were a video editor and you edit an iMovie and you're trying to tell me that you're a video editor, I would have no respect for you. It's a free software. It's on your phone, little features. Now, if you told me, I have Adobe Suite, you know, I have the Suite, Premiere, After Effects, Media Encoder, Photoshop, everything, Illustrator, I would be like, oh, you're legit then. So that's the kind of difference there, right? So like that's when like this is important. When I go on YouTube and see people go into CoinMarketCap and, you know, show the market cap and then they show the trading chart of whatever asset they're showing, I'm just like, where are you marking up support and resistance zones? Are you using your Fibonacci tool or you're not? So that's important. Let's get into some of the news for today. Let's start out with Casper. I know we kind of talked about last week why we are bullish on Casper, and we are going to continue that conversation today because You know, Tech Exchange Week was a monumental week this year, and, you know, it brought a lot of bad news to the Casper network with PruVi going to be on the Hedera blockchain. What happened that week was kind of like a little bit of management from Michael Storer going on the shows. You know, the people that talk about Casper, he came on our show and we discussed it. We did the interview, which was great. But after that, we've only seen progression out of the Casper network and from association with their DeFi calls, the AMAs, and everything. Actually, we haven't had an AMA since then, but with the DeFi calls, interaction with Casper fans. And here are some quick updates for you. Last week, we talked about you can now purchase Casper in your Ledger Live app, which is crucial. There's a new DePIN project coming to the Casper network. It's called Cal Network. It's being built on Casper. So that's very cool. We also have the Andra framework, which is to help developers efficientize tools on Casper. Finally here, this is what we talked about. This is going to come out around Tech Exchange Week, and now we're finally getting around to it. So here's a deadline here. It's supposed to be happening this week, ended this week, which is very important because when we talk about deadlines, we need deadlines to be hit for Casper now. There, the days of, you know, all right, we have PruVi tool coming out. You know, I know it's, well, Casper Labs PruVi, but the, you know, we got Andra, we got Casper 2.0 coming out, and then nothing comes from it. It's like, okay, well, those days are gone seemingly. So we have RC5, which is the pre-release to Casper 2.0 coming out. Very important. I did want to quickly talk about this Tandem wallet. I did some research on this Tandem wallet. I know it's been around for a while, but I never really got into it because I have my Ledger, I have my Trezor Matic. There's no real point. But Casper has officially been integrated into the Tandem wallet. I don't know why I kept saying Tandem. Tandem is a slim bank card. It's a plastic card. It has an antenna in it, and you just tap it with your phone, and it communicates. Problem is, it's mobile only. Wah, wah, wah. We're all on our desktop, T. We have our laptops. I remember when I bought my brother his Ledger, I didn't buy the one with Bluetooth, so he couldn't use it on his phone. So I just bought the one where it's like, hey, bro, plug it into your laptop. You're going to learn the right way. But the Tandem wallet is easy if you're on the go. You know, it's easy. And that's the thing. It's easy. You can use it with your phone, the app, and, of course, the private keys are stored on the card. Something I did want to talk about this because you guys might hear us talking about, oh, Casper integrated with Tandem wallet. Oh, I'll just get this wallet now. You know, even though we've talked about Ledger and Trezor forever, I'm going to get this wallet now. And honestly, I heard some people, and I think they're being paid by Tandem. The Tandem wallet doesn't have a screen on it, okay? And so when you're looking at your transaction, you're not able to look on it on your, like you would your Ledger or your Trezor or on another device. Even the Stacks, you can look at it. With the Tandem wallet, you're just verifying on your phone. You look at the transaction and you sign on there. And I don't know if I'm all about that. I know they haven't had any hacks or anything, and Ledger and Trezor has had hacks. I would say look at it. Maddie, are you looking to switch up your hardware wallet anytime soon? I know Dan showed me his Stacks, and I thought it was pretty pimp, to be honest, because it's very easy. You can move through it really quickly like you can your phone instead of like double-clicking with your Ledger. Are you looking to change up your hardware solution anytime soon?
I'm not moving providers. I'm a Ledger loyalist through and through. And again, not that I think that there's other, you know, cold storage or hardware solutions that there aren't great. There's plenty of competitors out there that are great. I've just been using Ledger products for so long now, and I've had just such a good consistent process for them that it's hard for me to deviate. My Ledger Flex, I should be taking delivery of that either end of this week, top of next week. I'm going to guess top of next week just because we're going to be in a lot of, you know, probably overload with the deliveries and stuff this week with the holiday coming up. But I should be taking delivery of that device sometime soon here, but I'm not deviating from the Ledger setup. I really enjoy that. You know, over time, maybe we're going to have also more cards that come out, maybe some, you know, additional features that come with the card where maybe you verify utilizing, you know, your phone and the card as kind of like a two-factor situation. But for me personally, I like my situation that it is now. We're not at a point where I'm running around and I'm able to play point of sale with crypto right now. So, you know, as it changes, I think that we'll probably just have the ability to utilize our devices directly to do, you know, Bluetooth tap to pay via our devices directly. So I'm not going to really move into these cards anytime soon. I'll probably be sticking with Ledger, and I'm sure they'll be releasing products as we start to take more payments, USDC at point of sale, whatever it might be, to use our devices directly.
Yes, your private keys are stored on your card, so you can just tap it with your phone. Your keys aren't displayed into your app, so you can't access your cryptos with just the app. You need your card. So the same thing as a Ledger here. Maddie, I did want to give you, what's the most bullish news out of the stock of Casper news we got this week?
You know, actually, it's a piece of news that I was just reading seconds ago, and it's that the tokens that were given to Casper Labs, the for-profit company, have been returned to Casper Association.
Oh, I missed
so
that.
Everyone get having a panic attack out there that, you know, Casper Labs is going to be dumping, you know, hundreds of millions of Casper back in the Casper Association wallet. So you guys don't have to fret about being dumped on. That's massive news. But, you know, Cal Network coming online is a big deal. You know, for DPIND, a lot of people overlook DPIND. DPIND is, by the way, decentralized physical infrastructure network. So, and that can point to a lot of things, right? So that could be GPU rendering. That could be for VPNs. It could be for a variety of things. So that really can also just relate to just kind of real world asset tokenization as well. So that's very exciting. But I would say that news that I just shared with you guys about these tokens being returned is a very big deal.
Wow, that is awesome. Yeah, you can see that on Casper.live right now. That is awesome. You can go check that out on your own time, team. But Maddie, thank you for bringing that there. I don't know how I missed that. Did that just happen right now when we started?
I literally got pinged about that while we were filming live here. I was like, you know what? I'm sorry. I got to bring this on the show here. I would hate not to bring it on. But definitely, guys, check out Cal Network, though, because I want you guys to see that this is a very similar competitor to maybe you guys have heard of like Peak or Crest. Kevin Gage talks about those a lot. This is a very similar ecosystem setup, bringing DPIND onto another existing network. So definitely check out Cal Network.
All right, let's move along here. Archax provides access to Aberdeen Money Market Fund on the XRP Ledger in collaboration with Ripple. So UK's first real-world asset exchange, custodian, and broker, and registered crypto exchange. They've been collaborating with Ripple since 2022 and, you know, enhanced that relationship in 2023, are now bringing real-world assets and tokenizing them, or taking that real world asset, that money market, and tokenizing it on the XRP ledger. So you have access to this money market account, this money market fund, I should say, on the XRP ledger. Maddie, how massive is this for the XRP ledger? This kind of sets the XRP ledger apart from other blockchains here with this, you know, this is a major move.
You know, there's been a lot of sandboxing of this type of deployment for a while now. We have Siemens, I want to say about a year and some change ago, tokenized some bonds directly on some blockchains, and we're able to distribute those directly to investors. You're cutting out the middleman. You're saving a lot of fees by being able to distribute and purchase directly. So what we're doing here is we're not only saving fees and we're increasing accessibility. What we're also doing is creating instant finality. So remember, guys, XRP Ledger, not only is it cheap, it's very fast, meaning in a matter of seconds, 1 to 2 seconds on average, you have instant finality. So, you know, whether you're getting into the fund or getting out of the fund, you're going to have access to those funds a lot more quickly as if you, for example, you're using, you know, that ACH transfer in and out of a fund. You're able to access those funds directly on the XRP ledger with finality in and out. And then, of course, you know, whatever you do with your XRP or your USDC that's maybe wrapped on the XRP ledger, you can do with what those funds what you want. But this is just a very small example. Like we talked about in the past, that's one real world asset. You can get even further with that with tangible items and tie those with NFTs. Because remember, XLS20 enabled NFTs on the XRP ledgers. So what does that really mean? It just takes people creating software and side chains where you have real estate being tokenized and vehicles being tokenized and maybe other high value items like Rolexes and whatnot being tokenized and being able to put on the XRP ledger, traded, instant finality, variety of things. So very excited to see more RWA on the XRP ledger.
That is directly bullish for XRP and, you know, the XRP ledger. But here's something that's indirectly bullish for XRP. Last week we saw, well, we heard murmurs and we saw a statement by SEC Chairman Gary Gensler talking about his time at the SEC and how productive it was. And then last week, just a couple days after we talked about, like, hey, I think this guy's going to resign here, SEC Chair Gary Gensler will step down January 20th, make way for Trump replacement. So, Maddie, he's resigning. He's getting out of here. He doesn't want the smoke anymore. And so, Maddie, what does this really mean for the crypto market? I know we've had big battles here, SEC v. Ripple, which was a monumental moment for the crypto industry and specifically for the digital asset XRP here. What does this mean for the future here? Because we kind of saw like a big flurry reaction after this news.
Yeah, you know, no matter what you put in there next, it's most likely going to be a massive improvement over Gary Gensler's reign. First of all, fuck you, Gary, right? Like, I'm so glad this piece of shit decided to just decide that, you know, hey, I'm not even going to wait to get fired. I'm going to go ahead and do the right thing and just get the hell out of here. Destroyed the crypto industry here in America. Congratulations, Gary. You sent billions, if not trillions of dollars of innovation over into, you know, other islands that have zero regulations. But nonetheless, you know, people are very excited about incoming GOP administration. and potentially GOP pick. I really, really do hope, though, that we get somebody of the caliber of like a Hester Pierce crypto mom over as the chairman of the at the SEC, because we need someone that not only is understanding and passionate, but has like a greater understanding of what we need to do tooling wise and regulation wise in order to create pathways for exchanges and companies and other people to be able to create and stay here in America, right? Like, we need to give them a form that they can come and fill out if they are going to be a security or if they're going to be a digital asset registration. We need a form that people can very clearly fill out, right? And that was one of the big things that we argued about over the last 4 years and some change here, was that you cannot come in and register even if you wanted to. So whoever we get in there next, I hope that they have a strong understanding of DLT and blockchain, and that they also have a big passion for working with regulators to create a clear pathway so that we can keep as much innovation as possible here in America. So who will it be? We'll have to find out. I'm praying that we don't get another bureaucrat in there that's going to, you know, go ahead and cock block us and send more innovation over to, you know, Hong Kong and in Japan and a variety of other places in the world.
As long as they're not calling it a digital asset security, I think we'll be fine. I did want to point to Kalashi right now, which is a betting market, and they got who will be Trump's SEC chair. And I talked about Brian Brooks, I think, a couple shows ago, and he's on the board of Hedera, of the HBAR Foundation. And he's in second right now. So could we see Brian Brooks on the board of Hedera Foundation or HBAR Foundation as the SEC chairman? We'll have to wait and see here. But I think this is bullish nonetheless, getting Gary out of there, and hopefully a transition period at the SEC and a transition period for legal clarity for digital assets. I know Brad Garlinghouse has talked a lot about this because they want to make, you know, bigger steps and strides at Ripple. But we need the proper regulatory environment for that. So if that's coming in 2025, I'm all here for it. Maddie, the last thing I wanted to kind of talk about, I know we're kind of ripping through the show, and I think it's important that we do because, you know, we have other things to do today at CryptoCharge.com. But the last thing I kind of want for you today is to look at the charts. You know, we're closing out November here. What does the team need to know? Because we're getting towards Christmas. We're probably going to get to a big flurry time. I know people are predicting that Bitcoin's going to hit 100K this week. So what should the team know going into this holiday season?
You know, first of all, feel free to rub it in your friends and family's faces this November, because I know just two Novembers ago, we were having to explain to our family that FTX does not equal Bitcoin as, you know, the markets were crumbling. So first of all, you know, go take your victory lap. Feels good to have some conviction and, you know, not be the have tomatoes thrown at you at, you know, Thanksgiving dinner this year. But, you know, we've seen, like I said, a big pop in the markets here. You know, you can sometimes see a little bit of consolidation, and especially, you know, on some of the actual holidays we have where, you know, there's no trading volume. You know, you're going to have Christmas Day and Thanksgiving Day, and you're going to have some of these low liquidity events. So, you know, don't be jarred by that. You know, as we kind of head into Q1 next year, I think we're going to continue to see some exciting price action. But as I always mention, guys, don't buy big green candles. Don't chase. Let price come to you. You know, stick to the plan. Don't let, you know, these impulses change your overall main profit-taking plan. Stick to what you've created for yourself. And you don't have a plan for yourself, time to create one. Get over at CryptoCharge.com. We'll help you guys create that plan. We have plans in the Coin Library. We have support over in the Discord for you guys. We have our live shows Monday through Friday to keep you guys plugged in. Don't go it alone. Have a plan. Stick to the plan.
Maddie, I wanted to get some charting, bro. What's going on here?
Did you want some charting? I didn't hear you ask for any at all.
Yeah, that was my intro, bro. I did. I said, hey, give me some charting. Close us out here. What should they know going into the holiday season?
What do you guys want to know to the holiday season? All right, so Bitcoin specifically, guys, we pretty much reached out almost to the perfect 1.618 up here. So I'm going to pull you guys really quick. So you guys can see from this flagging structure, we came very close. So I think we reached out to $99,000 or so. I actually met with a couple of people this week who had a pretty big Bitcoin holding that they acquired, you know, sub $30,000. And they're like, when should I start taking profits? I'm like, probably now is a good time, right? Like, let's take a piece out of the market. And I think people are just like so afraid of not being a part of the party of, you know, $230,000, $250,000. And it's like, who cares, right? Like, you did the job, right? You did the leg from that you wanted from, you know, 30K up to like 99.99K, you know, taking profit now versus 102 really isn't that important to me. So, you know, if you guys are looking at Bitcoin and you guys have built a Bitcoin position, you know, 30, 35K, it's probably time to start peeling a little out of the market. Why? Because the altcoins are starting to wake up, right? Like, it doesn't make sense to chase what another 2X potentially out of this market in the Bitcoin market when you could be taking at least some of that and still leave some Bitcoin exposure and rotating that into some alts right now. So I would definitely, if you guys are in Bitcoin right now, right, like that 99K is not on the table right now. We're at 94, 95,000, you know, give or take, depending on how many years are watching this. But, you know, don't get greedy with it. You know, these impulses do eventually correct, right? You're going to be like, damn, damn, we're down like 25%. And, you know, obviously people are going to be calling for the bear market again. I won't be in that spot. But don't be in the spot when you know that there's predetermined targets you guys should be looking to peel some off the table, and then just being greedy and be like, well, I want to wait another 1.8% until it gets up to that price point, and then I'll take a little profit. There's never a bad time to take profit, right? If you find yourself sending screenshots to your friends and family, it's probably time to take a little off the table, right? So especially with the altcoins here, guys, like we've got XRP breaking out very nicely. Don't chase XRP at a $1.45, $1.50, right? I think we need to cool off a little bit here. XLM definitely needs to cool off here. I'm definitely still focused right now on API3, Casper, maybe even a little bit of H&T just because we've been creating a really nice higher low here. I'm really trying to get my team focused on bunkering into the assets that have yet to make that big impulsive move yet, because those are the ones that are more keen on making a 2-3x from that next, you know, current price of that big pocket, versus, hey, I think it could go another 30% from here, right? Like what are we gambling all of this raising our average for, just to get a little bit more XRP up to that next leg? So again, guys, try to be patient here. Don't buy into these impulses. Corrections do come. You guys can look at so many examples in previous bull markets, and, you know, especially when everyone gets excited, oh, this time's different. You know, there'll be very shallow pullbacks, 5% to the downside. Don't worry about it, right? And then you do get that big, you know, 30 to 50% correction. And then you wish that you had been a little bit more patient and not taking all the dry powder out of, you know, your family savings account and crammed it all in on a big impulse candle. So, you know, it could always leave without you, but have some technical rules for yourself. Be patient, be tactical, and don't let the market makers, toy you into this. That's what they count on, is that you guys are going to FOMO into the top of these candles. That's how they make money. So be a part of it, don't be a part of it, but I'd rather you guys not be the victims of exit liquidity.
Wise words, Maddie. It's easier said than done when you've been accumulating the bear market and you know right now it's like, okay, it's time to let off the brakes, stack your cash bag, be ready on the pullbacks, or just jump on the opportunities right now that are being seen with API3, HNT, like you just discussed. If you're jumping in right now, it's probably a bunch of fuzziness to you. You're seeing the meme coins. Funny enough, Maddie, we're talking about in the bear market, it's like, okay, this is talked about by your average basic person that talks about crypto. They're like, oh, when Coinbase is like at the top of the App Store, that's the sell signal. You know what's the leading crypto-related app at the top of the App Store right now? It's the Phantom Wallet, Maddie. Can you believe that? The Phantom Wallet? For people to store their meme coins, the Phantom Wallet is the end-all, be-all crypto app at the top of the App Store right now. So it just goes to show you, it's like, man, meme coins are at the forefront of what everyone's doing right now. Good luck to you guys. I'm not participating in that. I'm going to continue to build my API3 bags. I'm going to continue to build my Casper bags. I'm going to start building that back up again on a pullback. But these are those opportunities to do that. Don't get consumed by Twitter that you're seeing screenshots of people making this or that money, because that is, you know, probably not really what's happening. I caught some guy on TikTok the other day. He FUDded his coin stats to make it show that he had like 200K in his coin stats account. And he just manually typed it in, Maddie. And I was just what is the world coming to? So team, you can't listen to everyone out there. We know there's the people, the influencers that, you know, just lie or don't know all the facts. Team, you have to be very strategic going into this time, all right? Don't believe everything you see. Do the research yourself to come to the conclusions that will ultimately set you up for success this bull run, if that makes sense. Team, that's all we have for today. I think that was a good show. Be back this Wednesday, 2:30 p.m. Pacific, for the Ask Maddie Show. If you have questions, leave them in the comment section down below. Make sure they're good, and I will bring them on the show. All right, team, see you Wednesday. Bye.